Would you like to learn how to make a delicious spatchcock chicken? Just like
well, in this episode of the Lisa D Delight Show, I'm going to show you how to make the most delicious herb and garlic spatchcock chicken. We're going to use some yummy garlic and herbs and lemon. You make your herb and garlic spatchcock chicken like this, it's guaranteed to be super yummy.
Lisa D Delight. Got noises in my stomach, so I guess I'm feeling hungry. I click that YouTube Lisa D so I can cut this rumbling. But when I'm in the kitchen, don't know what I'm doing, stumbling.
Okay, LDD family, let's get into this recipe. As usual, your shopping list and measurements and such will be in the description box below. But for starters, of course, you're going to need a whole chicken, some fresh garlic, lemon, bell peppers, and some better than bouillon roasted chicken base. First, let's start by removing this chicken booty. Child, I don't want no chicken booty cooties. Oh, and also be sure to remove the neck and gizzards. You're going to need a really, really sharp pair of kitchen shears in order to make this spatchcock chicken. You could also use a really sharp knife, but the kitchen shears just makes it more easy. You just want to find his backbone and begin to cut up from the bottom up to the neck alongside of the backbone. On each side of it. Spatchcocking chicken started in Ireland a long, long time ago. It's an abbreviation for dispatch the cock. Hey, go figure. But I love to make spatchcock chicken for a couple of reasons. One, it's easier to get all up in the inside and clean it thoroughly. So I cleaned the outside of the chicken already with lemon juice. And then once I dispatch the cock, I also rinse out the inside of the bird as well. Spatchcocking is also great because you get to have easy access to the inside and you can season it real good and get it all yummied up inside and out. And also a flat chicken takes less time to cook, which means the breast meat doesn't get overdone as it waits for the leg and the thigh meat to cook. So you end up with a moister breast. Is that even a word? Moister? More moist. Child, you know what I mean. You know you like your breast moist. Girl, it's a family show. So once you're done cracking his back, you just want to pull out his backbone. Pull it on at, like that. And you can save that and the gizzards and make you a good old gravy or some chicken soup. And then once you get him all spread high and wide, you want to go ahead and rinse out the inside. Use a little bit of lemon juice and get him so fresh and so clean. And then in order to get him to lay really flat, we have to crack his breastbone. So you just take a sharp knife and put a slit down the breastbone and open him up wide like so. I missed some of the fat over here, but do you know what would go really good with this spatchcock chicken? This delicious stuffing that I made enhanced with smoked turkey and sage? You have to check out that recipe above. You're welcome. Now let's make our seasoning paste to get our spatchcock chicken all yummified. We want to go in with a little Lawry's, a little garlic powder, and some onion powder. And this next seasoning is my new favorite seasoning. It is so delicious. It has the perfect blend of garlic and herbs in it. I get it from Pampers Chef. I'll put the link in the description box below in case you're interested. And then go in with one packet of Sazon, smoked paprika, and some Italian seasoning. This spatchcock chicken is the perfect recipe when you don't want to have turkey for Thanksgiving or Christmas. If you're tired of turkey, just roast you one of these spatchcock chickens. And if you really want to be saying something, you can make some bourbon honey glazed carrots to go with the spatchcock chicken. Oh, you don't know how to make the carrots? Child, I got you. Recipe above. Next, go in with some fresh cracked black pepper. Fresh cracked black pepper is so much more flavorful than the black pepper that's already ground. Then add in a little of Better Than Bouillon chicken base. Some of you already know that I love Better Than Bouillon products. All of their products are super flavorful and pretty much adds a yummy bang to any recipe.
Branch & Vine is a gourmet, high quality, extra virgin olive oil.
You know all olive oils aren't the same, but I love Branch and Vine because it's infused with butter, so it adds a smooth and delicious taste of butter to so many dishes like veggies, pastas, meats, potatoes, and so much more. They also have other flavors like garlic, basil, scallions. So if you wanna elevate the flavor of your recipes, try Branch and Vine.
Branch and Vine is not a sponsor to this video, but I just happen to love their products. And you can find that olive oil at branchandvine.com. So then go ahead and mix the seasonings all up, stir, stir, stir. And you're looking for a consistency, something like this, so that it's nice and easy to spread on our spatchcock chicken. So we're going to season the inside of the chicken first. Go ahead and add a little of our yummy seasoning mixture all over the inside. And we're gonna use our hands and massage the seasoning into the chicken so that it gets all up in every nook and every crevice. Just make sure that your hands are impeccably clean. Shout out to my girl Gina Young. Oh, I came up with a name for our spatchcock chicken. Her name is Big Body Brenda. So flip Big Body Brenda up on her other side so that we can season up the top of Brenda's breast scissors. You just want to be sure to get all of the seasoning all over her neck, her back, her middle, and her crack. My sis Kaya ain't never steered you wrong. You just want to make sure you rub her up flip her real good. So once we seasoned up Miss Brenda all nicely, we want to get her ready with some aromatics to roast in the oven. First, we're going to go in with a little lemon, a few slices of lemon, and then we're going to go in with some red onions. Typically, I would use shallots, but I didn't have any, so basically any type of onion will do. And then we're gonna go down with some garlic cloves as well as some multicolored bell peppers. All of these aromatics are going to help penetrate amazing flavor up and through Miss Brenda as she's roasting in the oven. So go ahead and place Miss Big Body Brenda up on top of the aromatics and be sure to pour any excess seasoning up on top of the spatchcock chicken. So apparently it's amateur night here on the Lisa D Delight Show because I forgot to put down the rosemary. Preheat your oven to 375, and as I said, spatchcock chickens take less time to cook. Big Body Brenda here is 5 pounds, and she took 45 to 50 minutes to cook. But depending on the size of your bird, that can vary. But you just want to make sure that the internal temperature is 165.
Lisa D Delight.
You put her in the oven. You want to make sure that you put the legs towards the back of the oven because the back of the oven is hotter and you don't want the breast to overcook and dry out. But halfway through the cooking time, we're going to make a yummy butter sauce for Miss Brenda over here. We're going to add a full stick of butter to the pan and begin to baste the chicken. That's going to make it even more flavorful, juicy, and moist. I want to give a shout out to my girl, It's Birdie. It's Birdie has a really cool channel. She does mukbanging and vlogging over there. Please go check her out. And if you like what you see, please subscribe. Her link will be in my description box and pinned in my comments. And if you too would like a shout out, simply tell me how many times I said the word spatchcock or spatchcock chicken in this video, and I'll give you a shout out in my next one. So place Big Body Brenda back in the oven until she reaches the internal temperature of 165.
Lisa
go Big Body Brenda, yummy, juicy. Go Big Body Brenda, yummy, juicy. This spatchcock chicken was mind-spinningly good. And thank you to my Lord and Savior for always blessing me and the LDD family. Father God, we love you, appreciate you, and praise you for every single thing. Child, I'm telling you, make your spatchcock chicken like this, and you can thank me later. This recipe is just super yummy. But the Chief Tasting Officer, Mace, is in the building. So let's see what he has to say. Mace. Oh, Mace. You just can't get good help these days.
You
want
to taste the chicken? You ready to work? Is it good? Is it yummy? You like it? You approve?
There you have it. Quality control approved. Now all you need to do is bless your life and make my macaroni and cheese recipe to go with this spatchcock chicken, and you'll be straight for any holiday dinner or even just a regular old any day of the week dinner. You're welcome. Always remember, when you cook from your heart with love, you can't go wrong. Have a delicious and delightful day. God bless you. Bye. Make sure you like and subscribe and you make it so good.